So what they would usually do is after they've gathered this ball, and like we said, he's looking for a potential mate. Once he's found a female, then she would normally be the one that sits on the ball. She doesn't do any of the moving of the ball. He sits on the ball every now and then as he pushes it, not entirely sure where he decides to go, but to navigate as well. He would push the ball. He doesn't done it yet, but he would eventually stop, and he gets on top of the ball and he turns in a little circle just to navigate himself, and then he continues again. And apparently, not exactly sure how it works, but these guys do use the stars to navigate as well. If you go back to, if you go look at different kinds of dung beetles.
Really?
There's many.
Oh, wow.
Many. If you go to a fresh pile of dung, like in the next few months coming, and you go and scratch, or even sometimes you'll see the dung moving with all the dung beetles. Big ones, small ones, different colored ones. Some of them make their own balls. Some are like kleptoparasites, where they would steal. They'll just wait for someone to make a ball, and then they would come in and try and steal the ball. Most of them can fly. And then there's one that's very endangered, the only one that cannot fly, that lives in Addo National Park on the East Coast, or sorry, on I think Port Elizabeth. And that one is highly endangered purely because they are able to fly.